Hi, my name is Chris, and this is Battle Nonsense. My first test of Escape from Tarkov did not only break the design of my results graphic, it also seems to have triggered one of the guys from Battlestate Games as he lashed out on Reddit in a very unprofessional way since he did not agree with my results. Some of you will know which topic I'm referring to. So even though there already were plenty of videos highlighting the netcode issues prior to the release of my netcode analysis, I was happy that I could provide players with more detailed data which showed how bad the network delay and desync really were. Now, despite that incident on Reddit which I chose not to engage in as the community already took care of that, I want you to know that the conversations that I had and still have with the network developer at Battlestate Games were always very professional and productive. Players are often quick to blame the entire studio over the actions of one person. What I want you to keep in mind is that in every development studio there are many people working hard on the game who are not like that. So don't blame an entire studio over the actions of a single person. Now, if you haven't seen my first netcode analysis for Escape from Tarkov, then you can find a link to that video in the description down below. In case that this is the first time that you watch one of my videos, I want to say welcome to my channel, and please watch my Netcode 101 video first or right after this one to learn more about tick rates, update rates, network models, super bullets, lag compensation or packet loss, as well as a few other things like how I do my network delay tests. The reason why I no longer include this basic information in every video is not to get you to watch more of my videos. I was asked to keep the netcode analysis videos as short as possible, so I had to put all this information into the separate Netcode 101 video. The card overlay in the top right corner of this video, as well as the link in the description down below, will both take you directly to that video. So when I test the game, then I will not only run my tests on different servers, I also repeat them on different days and maps to make sure that my results are as accurate as possible. Usually the results of these test runs don't differ much, which is why I can show you just one set of results in my videos. But should there be a big difference between the test runs, then I do show and explain that in the video. So when I tested version 0.7 of Escape from Tarkov, the results of these different test runs were all very similar and extremely bad. I had never seen anything like this in the 4 years that I'm now running this YouTube channel, and that's quite an achievement when you consider that the terrible netcode that Battlefield 4 launched with is the reason why this channel exists. So last week Battlestate Games released patch 0.8, which among many other things should have decreased the network delay quite a bit. So I tested the game again during the last few days, and while the delays are still too long when compared to other first-person shooters, they are much, much, much better than what players had to deal with before patch 0.8. That said, players seem to have been confused by the statement that some optimizations are only available on the new map. These optimizations are, however, only for the frame rate. The netcode is the same across all maps. The reason why your experience might still differ between maps is that your frame rate has a big impact on your online experience, especially when you consider that the firing rate of the gun is linked to your frame rate. That is an issue that the developers intend to fix in one of the next patches. Now, when you take a look at the shortest and average delays, then you will notice that damage and player movement have significantly more delay than gunfire. Another thing is that in version 0.7 there was always a massive hiccup which caused a longest delay of nearly 1 second. In 0.8 it's not even remotely as bad as it was in 0.7, but that hiccup is still there, so that in every test run I would get at least one sample with a delay of more than 150 milliseconds at a player ping of just 17 milliseconds to the game server. Here you can see one of these delay spikes next to a sample which shows a gunfire delay of 55 milliseconds. This is something that the developers must fix as soon as possible, as a consistent network delay is very important for a good online experience. Now, while we are talking about network hiccups, I want to show you an issue that occurred just one single time while I was running my tests, which is why I didn't include it in my network delay results. So here you can see one of the test runs where one player fires his gun and the other player then sees the gunfire. But right after this one I fired 3 shots which the other player didn't see at all. Sadly, I didn't fire right at that player in this test, as that would have been very interesting to know if these shots would have hurt that player. So, as I said, this happened just one single time. In every other test run, the other player could see all the fired shots. Nevertheless, this is a concerning issue when it comes to the quality of the game's networking. Doors are also still a problem in Escape from Tarkov. I noticed that when I open and close a door 15 times, then at least once there will be a delay of about 3 seconds until the door just opens instantly. This is an issue that other players have noticed as well, as they had enemy players teleport through a door that was still closed on their monitor. Obviously, this is a major issue that the developers must fix as soon as possible. Another thing that didn't change with version 0.8 is the lag compensation. The game will always confirm a hit even when you get shot by a player who has a ping of 200 milliseconds to the game server, while you might have a ping of just 17 milliseconds to the server. This is not a good experience in a game where the stakes are as high as they are in Escape from Tarkov. So, when we look at the test results from 0.8 and 0.7, then the developers clearly made some massive improvements. But they still must work on those delays, as they are way too long when you consider that my test players had a ping of just 17 milliseconds to the game server. But for a good online experience, it is not only necessary to bring the delays down, they must also be consistent. Those spikes of more than 150 milliseconds are by no means as bad as what we had in version 0.7, but they are still very noticeable and lead to a bad experience for the player. So the developers clearly made some big improvements here, which players should benefit from. However, you must ask the question if they had to make compromises to achieve these lower delays, as players have noticed that in version 0.8 there don't seem to be as many bots as there were in version 0.7. If the AI was causing the insane delays in 0.7, then scaling it down is a reasonable, temporary solution. According to the network developer that I've been talking to, a new network architecture for Escape from Tarkov is currently in development. So I guess that we will have to wait and see what kind of impact that will have on the game once it gets implemented, which I think won't happen anytime soon if they really swap out the entire underlying network architecture. Now, before I end the video, I want to show you how many kilobits per second Escape from Tarkov sends and receives when you play online. As always, please keep in mind that this is not a rating nor a ranking. I just want to show you how much bandwidth these games need, so that you get a better idea if your connection can handle these games. And that's all for today. I will keep you updated on the progress that the developers make, and if you enjoyed this updated netcode analysis of Escape from Tarkov, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough anymore to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would not exist anymore. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.